finally sort of narrow it down to the direction that you wanted to take? Let's talk about the work that you did for the gala dinner.
Well, actually, my team and I did some researching regarding the characters of the personalities of the president.
Right.
And we came up with the different characters of the Filipinos. So that's how we named the barongs.
Okay. So I understand that there was some qualities that you wanted in there. Magiting, magiliw, marangal,
exactly.
Mapayapa, magalang,
yes.
and such. But even the decision to go with a barong or barotsaya and other designs, I believe you try to represent, making sure that the influences from the Visayas, Luzon and Mindanao as well were present there. How did you pick and choose, considering there's so much inspiration to draw from?
Well, because like what I did for the for the leaders, for the heads of state, was. I really came up with a design which would fit each and everyone's personality.
Right.
So I stick my concept to a traditional barong, especially the embroidery. Mm-hmm. I didn't make any modern touch, so it's all purely Filipino.
Right. Let's talk about some of the materials that were used here. You wanted to present really the best that the Philippines is
of
known
course.
For. What materials did you choose? Type of profiles? You keep talking about keeping things simple, austere, but at the same time highlighting really the craftsmanship that we're famous for.
Well, what I use, the fabric that I use was the piña cocoon, and all are embroidered by hand. Mm-hmm. We also included the calado, and what is very good in this is I have the buttons custom made
okay.
with the ASEAN logo on it.
Wow, fantastic. So there was a lot of, the big question marks always, is this leader going to wear what we designed for them? Is he going to be comfortable wearing that? How did you get around issues like that for particularly Westerners who may not feel so comfortable in our type of dress, which I feel is the most appropriate thing to wear, really, given our weather?
Oh, yes. First, I have to take into consideration of President Duterte's, because like President Duterte, he feels like not too comfortable with the collar clothes.
Right.
So what I did for him was, it was not a button collar.
Okay.
And what I did also is the lining, I use, cotton silk, so it will be very soft and breathable, so everyone will feel comfortable. As what, when I had the fitting with Prime Minister Trudeau yesterday, he said that he was very happy because I used that kind of lining that he doesn't have to wear an undershirt.
Okay. Prime Minister Trudeau is certainly he looks very comfortable in this type of dress. Who do you think took some convincing? Like, there was a lot of talk about whether or not President Trump would actually be comfortable in his barong. It looked like he pulled it off, though.
Oh, yes, because his barong was sent like a month ago. Mm-hmm. So there would be like the final fitting for him in the States. And
right.
if there would be alterations to be done, it can be done early.
Okay, well, it's a little simpler. Perhaps I'm simplifying it, but it's a little simpler to design something for men, being that you're within the confines of a traditional barong. What about for the spouses and for women leaders, perhaps? Is it a little more difficult or a little more involved?
Oh, not really, because I'm really very good at women's line.
Okay.
So it was easy for me, but I still have to stick to the traditional Filipino touch.
Okay, now you hear the term often, fashion diplomacy. What does that mean to you?
Come again.
We often hear the term fashion diplomacy, or diplomacy through fashion. What do you think that means, and how important is that?
Well, it's very important because, like, for the ASEAN leaders to wear the barong, this will be taken back to their own country, and it would be an honor. Like, it is an honor for me to dress up 20 heads of state as they bring back the barong to their own country and have the Filipino spirit in their hearts.
Okay, what kind of feedback? I mean, you had Mr. Trudeau say that it was comfortable and he was looking forward to donning the barong, and it was the type of garment that he was comfortable wearing. What other feedback did you get from some of the other people who may have been wearing a barong for the first time, perhaps?
Well, thank God, because all the measurements were just given to us,
right,
by the different embassies of the heads of state. Mm-hmm. And there was no alteration at all, but not like just for President Trudeau, we just have to taper it down, like slim it down.
Right.
And everything's perfect, thank God.
Good stuff. Going back again to the spouses, what kind of designs or outfits did you guys put together for many of these leaders' spouses?
Well, the inspiration was the typical terno, mm-hmm. but then we researched the personality again of the spouses. So mm-hmm. I, like, two of them were a little conservative, like close neck, long sleeves.
Right.
So of course, what I did, like a long sleeves, typical barong dress.
Mm-hmm. How do you? What's the process? Do you design something, send the sketches out, and then come up with a sample? It must be hard to coordinate, getting something made for somebody who's not actually there for the fitting. Are there any particular difficulties with working that way?
Oh yes, because like what I said, we did a lot of researching mm-hmm. regarding the individual who's gonna wear it, and then we talk about it, like the whole team talk about it. We have to lay down the different embroidery patterns, mm-hmm. which is gonna fit each and every one of them, and then we come up to the final design, the final embroidery, final pattern, final cut. But it has to be very cohesive, like the 20 ASEAN leaders, the barong should be very cohesive, the mm-hmm. collection.
Right. Okay, it's hard to play favorites, but let's have a little fun here. Who do you think is the best dressed? Who wore it best, as we like to say?
For me, it's President Duterte and Prime Minister Trudeau.
There you go. All right. Best of both worlds.